and he's breathing into it well, and it's not a, it's sore from it, it's not overwhelming. Not overwhelming, is it?
Overwhelmed.
Yeah. And then we can start to just gently do what I call the gentle shake, which is just holding those points and just gently.
I don't think he needs help.
Yeah. He's releasing. Then I'm going to combine that with a few caressing, stroking moves. And then a couple more.
You can see that inside bend too.
Yeah.
Protrude a bit.
And then we're just gently, again, I'm just going to find that, just that right amount of pressure for him.
Nothing wrong with that.
Just so what he can deal with. And then starting to caress up through here. He's doing well. Notice how the leg is starting to get more of a loose, floppy kind of feeling. It's flopping off the table. Let's have a quick look now and compare his legs. See if you can notice how now, look at the pressure here and here.
Doing it all, is that how quick you would do it, or would you slow it right down?
No, I'll do it like that. Because he's going to get better results. Because he's breathing into it. Even though he's dramatic, he's enjoying it. You know what I mean? He's just carrying on with it. He just likes to breathe it. But with other people, if they're not being able to breathe into it, if they're tightening up, ease off. Only go the amount the person can breathe into, and if their rate of breath increases, you've got to slow your pace down.
Yeah,
it depends on the person a little bit, and the style and that kind of thing. You can do, it's not one's right, one's wrong.
Yeah.
They'll produce slightly different effects.
But then there's definitely a difference.
You can get a lot more done if you work.
Well,
you know, he's going to produce. I'm working near his maximum.
No,
so I'm going to achieve a lot more.
Probably
a short period of time. So he's going to put more value for
my
time.
And I've given him thousands.
Yeah, but see, some people are going to be really small, especially people that are certain nervous conditions and anxious conditions. I'll be really slow and steady and nurturing.
Yeah.
With him, I just want to break up some of this thing and just let him go through it. You know what I mean? It's not so. So it's different times for different massages. Yeah.
I thought that was
more
that
one. So can you feel any difference now in his legs, especially the sides? And
I just noticed that his toe is sitting lower now.
Yeah.
You can also see how all these veins now are bringing blood to the areas I've worked, more so than on that side, yeah? Even through his calf muscles. So all that area now is getting blood that didn't have, it was blocked before.
It's alive.
Yeah.
Well, it's still alive.
Yeah.
Does it mean that on the left side
it's going to
be as intense as the right?
Yeah. He's tight all over, so he's not necessarily tight on one. I don't know, he's just tight.
It's pretty equidistant. I work on keeping my body balanced.
Some people have one leg really tight and the other one not so bad. You work on the tight one. Sometimes you work on the looser one first if they really can't handle things. So you build them up to it, they get used to it, and then work on the tighter one. But
what does the muscle spasm mean that he's getting in here? Is that just an energy release? Or?
Yeah, that's the chi release.
Oh,
did
you see some? Yeah, I've seen about three.
Little
flickers. Yeah, that's energy releasing.
They
can go full on.
No,
but
I can't
feel
what
the
pain. I'm not like it.
Yeah. And how do you feel from one leg to the other?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah. I'm not seeing it at the right angle.
It's just like little stitches, aren't they?
Oh, how can I say? Looser.
Yeah.
But the leg itself actually feels like light. This leg feels heavy compared to this leg. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I can see it from here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, don't worry, I get them all the time. I can still get Charlie horses in the middle of the night in the back of my hamstrings. I was supposed to get over there with my teenagers.
All right, yeah, what I keep losing my world off. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, so we'll balance it out now.
Here we go.
Raptor.
But you can see, it's like, even though he's making these like dramatic things, he's enjoying it, you know? Underneath it, he loves it.
Yeah.
You don't mind if I speak for you there?
Yeah. I'm enjoying it because I'm actually learning while you guys are learning, I mean.
Yeah. So again, we're just warming up gently here. Doing a bit of gentle caress of the little finger. It's good to vary. I like to vary what I use, so sometimes I'll use my thumbs. Sometimes I'd use my knuckles. He's getting a bit more used to it now, so I can go in with a bit of knuckles.
Yeah. That's true, you do get to become more desensitized. It's not hurting you as much as before.
Yeah.
Well, you know what to expect. Yeah. He's not on your feet yet, though.
I know where he is.
Yeah.
I know exactly where he is. But just comparing the different thighs, it's easy to deal with now. I know what to expect.
Yeah, exactly. There's not so much of that, oh my gosh, what's happening kind of feeling.
A lot of tension is apprehensions.
Yeah.
And if you have less apprehension,
you have breath going and things are moving a bit. When I click the toes, I do a little technique where I push off this knuckle thing, which has probably got some Latin name that I can't remember, but I push opposite that and then get the base of the toe. I just clicked them all before, I'm not going to click, but I'll show you more about that clicking a bit later. But that's how it's done. You get opposite this thing. See, I'm pushing opposite it, and I get below this joint. See this bottom joint of the toe? I'll get below it. I just did it as all of them like that, like doing all of them before, so that's why we're not clicking now. You heard those clicks, I did. Yeah. And that's how it's done. Don't do it like that, you'll force them like that. You gotta get below that joint and then opposite that one. Whether it's the thumb or the finger. Okay, and you can do them all like by doing it like that as well. Now I'm just starting to caress across the top of his foot here. Not too hard. Yeah.
Gentle caress.
Yeah. My trademark. It's a very important pressure point right in between these two toes here. So it's below these knuckles and just applying a bit of pressure. And just, again, we can hold and shake it.
That's the stomach.
Yeah. That's the basis of all this tension coming up. So if somebody might have a bad knee, it could be. If it's coming through here, it's because of here. If it's coming from the side, it's from this little toe. And then they come up like that and into the belly. And then up into the chest and into the neck.
If you've had someone that's had a knee reconstruction, can you use that point?
Yes, you can. No, as long as it wasn't recent. Like the last few months or something. And again, we can just gently apply pressure through here. Again, not too hard, because it could be a bit uncomfortable for him. So here we're just gently going in there. And then coming across the top here. And right up. Again, just starting to caress gently through, all the way up. You can also do things like this where we hold the bottom. This band comes extremely close to the shin bone, okay? It's not way out here, it's right beside it. You'll see it a bit through here. You can see how it's flicking over there? That's how you know the difference between a bone and a muscle. There's like a, it's, see how it's flicking underneath my finger right there?
Is that a tendon?
Yeah, bands are composed of like tendon and muscle, because all tendons are, muscle comes here and then the tendon joins it to the bone. Mm. So we work the whole lot. And we don't really worry whether it's tendon or muscle.
Oh.
If it's tight, we want it loose. So he's doing well with his breathing. Got a little click out of his big toe there. They're usually hard to get. I'm going to come in again and just work gently on the sides of his big toe. And again, the most important thing is that he's comfortable.
This is the most uncomfortable, comfortable I've been in my life. You're like my dentist.
Yeah.
Nice people, you're doing good for me, but I want to smack you.
Yeah. Oh. So that's again when we work through that inner band, it comes right in through here. But as I say, a lot of people find this tension in the ball of the calf muscle and overwork this. It actually comes from through here that they need to work, right into the side of the big toe. Okay, so we're more wanting to caress through there. And up and around. And then we can start to gently shake through that calf muscle a little bit. And we can give him a rest from that band and start to come into this band here. And again, just caressing around the ankle. And up to here. And we can just let him breathe. A little bit uncomfortable for him, but not too bad.
Sorry about my growling, guys. It's just my way.
Yeah. Don't be sorry. You just gotta let it out. Yeah. Okay, so again, so it's pretty simple kind of stuff. We're just finding the roots of the bands. Here you won't feel the band, but you know where it goes because you can often see it. It curls around the ankle. And you'll lose it through here, but it comes.
Oh!
Keep falling.
Shit!
You can even come into there a little bit and then just push it through there. And coming through again. Not too bad. And you can see now his leg's starting to let go. See that? How it's really, the tension's just going out of the leg. He's able to handle it deeper. See, remember before, knuckles were quite uncomfortable for him. Now it's easy for him, relatively. So you can see he's released quite easily. He's almost ready for the deeper moves through his knees here. And main thing is we just get him to breathe in. We could go even more gently just by holding him here and just gently rolling them. It's a little bit uncomfortable for him. See how he's got that nice, the leg's now starting to get that nice floppiness to it, same as this one. It's starting to, it's got such a different feel to it than when we first started. And here, gently holding those points. As I say, some people do find this a little bit uncomfortable. Some people don't even want you to do it right away. And then we can get into it deeper and just caress it like a gentle shaking movement. And it's letting go along. These are very powerful, as I say. They can really get the chi moving in the body as well. So with this form of massage, sometimes the first treatment, even the second and third, can be a little bit uncomfortable when you're not used to it. And then what happens is you just start to really enjoy a really deep massage and just feels better all the time. Yeah, we can definitely see those legs just really letting go now. Alright.
So Brendan, what was the purpose of the towels on the table?
They never stay there when I work on them, you know? That's alright. People squirm around that much, you know? It's like, draping was never, you know.
That's why people love a squirmer.
Yeah. We have what we call squirmers, screamers, squealers, whingers. silent achievers, you know? So now I'm going to just gently start to work his belly a little bit. And I'm going to tune into his breath. So I'm going to get him to breathe in. And then I'm going to start to pump the belly a little bit.
On the
out-breath. Yeah, on the out-breath. Yeah. Hopefully not during. So as he breathes in, I'm not doing much. I do most of my work at the end of the out-breath. So I'm just warming his belly up more, just getting him, by doing this, I'm getting him to breathe into his belly. I'm starting to feel a bit of tightness in there. And just gently caressing it a bit. A lot of people threaten me with different things for that. What I'm going to do though, I like to loosen up. Before I get into people's bellies, I often like to loosen up the legs, but also the head. So it helps them to relax. So above and below a sensitive area. So now what I'm going to do is just gently come and start to work his head a little bit. Now, are your legs warm enough? So here I'm just going to start.